Well, alright, I said we were back to the analysis desk for the last time today, but that's not the case yet, because we had to throw to a quick break. We had some minor technical difficulties on our side, but everything should be fixed, and I do think we are about to get going. Neo, you're a man of storylines. We obviously spoke a lot about Hitman, but for Sock, this is also an absolutely amazing opportunity. Perhaps the biggest of his Warcraft 3 career so far.
Yeah, exactly. He has never been in these big Tier 1 tournaments as well. Not that far, of course. The DreamHack Seasons, yes. Apart from that, no. So I wonder, can he step out of the shadow of the Chemico? Can he be the new Infi and TH to carry the human flag? It's up to him now. He's the last remaining human player.
Yeah, absolutely. I think he's got what it takes to do it. I've been really impressed with him in the past. Caution's going to be casting. It's going to be a tough cast for him, by the way, because Hitman is his homie and, of course, from NA. But Sock is his favorite player and has been forever.
The love for Murica has no boundaries, mate. Let me tell you that much. I think he knows what he wants. We just want this awesome best of five to start, and I do believe the casters are ready. So Todd and Carson, take it away. Have fun. Go nuts.
Last series of the day, last North American of the entire tournament. Who will join Laliat in the semifinals? Todd, we're going to figure it out right now.
Let's do it. What a great match to end the day with. We've had so many amazing games, and we're hoping that this is another amazing series. Yes. You and I haven't been gifted with the closest series so far, yeah. Let's say. And I think this has potential to be a really good series, but also could be very one-sided for either player. It's really hard to tell how it's going to go down.
Absolutely, yeah. And plenty of different strategies we could see from both these guys, especially on the side of Sock. Yeah, we'll see if Hitman shows up to play or not today. And here we go, the first game in this best of five. In the bottom right of Shallow Grave, it is Hitman.
Opponents in the Northwest playing human as yellow player. It is Sock.
So, what do you think about this map in this matchup? Do you have much experience? Do you veto this map? Do you play it a bunch? I'm not sure really who it favors. I would say maybe human on paper, but maybe not.
I think Sock's altar placement tells me he wants to do the mercenary camp first,
right.
Which. On most maps, like let's say Northern Isle, if you want to do the Tusker camp first, you will get an Arcane Tower, but now you're right. Starting the game with the Troll Priest, so you might as well not even get that. So
Absolutely.
It's a little bit of a shortcut that you cut, and honestly, I want to agree with you. Like, I feel like if you can get that start where your tech's going to be slightly delayed, but you start with level 2 and a big consumable, that can be very good for a player like Sock. He's still getting the Scout Tower, regardless of that.
Yeah, getting it very defensively as well. Worth noting, Hitman going for the Grunt Opener, which means... he is going to creep right off the bat, probably the Lightning Shield to the right of his base, which is why I think Sock feels safe to go for his Mercenary Camp, so it's going to be a slight experience advantage for the Archmage, but the Farseer will get level 2 as well.
And, you know, I want to talk about the history of North America in Warcraft 3. You know, all memes aside, it's a region that's been great in the past, but that was long ago. That was when Warcraft was in its infancy with guys like Wizard,
right.
Going over to China for Akon in 2004, winning that. And then we had Short Rounds shortly after as well, taking fourth place WCG 2004 in San Francisco and a second place WCG 2005 behind Sky in 2005. After that, there were some pretty good players like Nilknar, for example, Heather,
right. Yep.
But never really on the same level, never really championship caliber or with podium finishes as much. Now, Hitman is the guy a decade and a half later to try and do that, to try and make a podium here, make it to the semifinals and leave his mark on the Warcraft stage forever.
Yeah, he's definitely carrying the mantle, carrying the torch right now. And everyone back at home, I'm sure, hoping he does not disappoint. But Sock is, of course, an excellent player, really made a name for himself in the last 4 or 5 years. Okay, level two, Potion of Vulnerability. Probably not the best consumable you could get, but the experience is where Sock is going to be happiest with.
Yeah. Sock, you know, we tried to talk a little bit about strategies and some of the options here for him.
Right.
The Beastmaster second is the big thing that he likes to do that he's been very successful against Hitman with. This is what I expect here on this map. But he can also throw in different strategies. Sometimes a fast expansion, sometimes that air strategy with
sure.
Griffins, which also would be very dangerous because it's still kind of new. Not many people know exactly how to react to that. And even against the Beastmaster, I think that's probably a big thing that Hitman has had to think about how exactly to go on to counter that style with the Beastmaster. Like, how aggressive do you want to play? Do you want to play defensive? Do you want to play aggressive? Do you
right.
want to expand at all? What units do you make?
Yeah. Yeah, and it's difficult because Thought can always just turn around and just go Panda. He can go Mountain King. He can play Rifle Caster if he wanted. The cards are all in Sock's hands strategically. Hitman is going to play very much cookie cutter. He's going to play reactionary, as Orc generally has to do. So Sock has the big upper hand, especially the earlier in the series we are. Berserker hired double trolls, and the turtle up for grabs. Chain Lightning will secure it, and that's going to deny the Archmage from getting any close to level 3 experience. Pretty close, which is going to be nice for Hitman, I think.
You know, I checked the match history actually on WT Champions this season alone, which has been going on for a few weeks. It's 19 wins for Sock, 8 wins for Hitman.
Okay, well, that's definitely heavily favoring Sock, but not as bad as I suppose it could be at times.
Well, it is kind of bad. And a lot of those games were with Archmage Beastmaster, so if I think of Hitman's style, he likes to play very standard with Headhunters, expand with Torrent Chieftain on tier 2, get Shamans. I would think that style should do well against the Beastmaster second, but apparently it doesn't because Sock has this great win record against Hitman on ladder. So Hitman hopefully has learned from that, and he brings a new, different touch here in this match that where he's seeing here, which is the important moment. Like really, if you're going to have, you know, 30% win rate against somebody,
right,
when you meet them in the tournament is when you want to use all of that to your advantage and try and get that very important win. Sock is going defense into a Blacksmith.
Yeah, with triple Mercs as well. He's got double Priest. He's going to have level 3 soon enough. And with those piercing damage mercenaries and the water elementals on top of it, he's going to be able to kill a burrow even with, you know, 7, 8, 9 peons repairing it if he has the position. Still needs to secure that level 3. But yeah, the Blacksmith is very unorthodox with this sort of an opener. Generally, you'll power creep level 3, then go for 2 Sanctums. Getting yourself ready for the late game, whereas Rifles, very much a timing-based army, I would argue.
I think it's maybe because his tech is so delayed with that strategy. Remember, he went for the mass militia creep on the Merc camp and made a tower, so his tech is like almost the slowest that you're ever going to see here. That he wants to get something going before he can even start some sort of double Sanctum. So he's going to go for Rifles first, and then maybe after that add some sort of double Sanctum down the line. But yeah, this is the dangerous timing here. Needs to get rid of the Water Elementals. That's the high damage units of Sock here. He's going to die for the Mercenaries here with a Speed Scroll. If he can get them, that's going to be a lot of experience. Fast here, he's already 3.4.
Yeah, the trap is set. Both priests go down. That's a ton of experience, but the burrows in the back could be taking some serious damage. I love the focus on the water elemental, by the way. Torrent Chieftain out now. That means stomp possibility.
Oh, not
going for the Arcane, or the Spirit Lodge, rather, yeah. And I think he's just going to lose everything here. Is he really going to get this canceled?
Okay, he can
might
save
not.
The Lodge. If Hitman prepares the peons to repair, I think he might even save that.
Oh my god.
A huge overextension by Sock, who's getting blocked.
Surround! Oh, unbelievable my god. Hitman! Potion of Vulnerability, and he's gonna get out, but Sock lost literally everything, Todd.
That is ridiculous. Like this one rifle making its way across the map, he's gonna have to run home as well. We got a second rifle on the way, and it's Mountain King. He's not playing with a Beastmaster that he's had so much success with on the ladder. But instead playing, you know, almost like the old meta, right? Where it's very standard to go for Rifle Caster, but you only make a few rifles.
For sure.
You basically make the Orc go into grunts, and then you go for Second Sanctum to counter that with a lot of Sorceresses.
Yeah, that's actually an excellent choice, I think, against Hitman in particular, because when Hitman sees Rifle Caster, when he sees the Blacksmith, he just goes pure Grunt Shaman with upgrades and doesn't expand. And then later when he sees the second Sanctum, he'll get the Bestiary as a reaction to the casters. But maybe Sock is aware of this and is going to do that just 2-3 rifles into immediate double Sanctum. I think that's a great choice if Sock is aware of how Hitman plays.
Just a rough start. Because of all that he lost, now the TC is also already 2.6 because he was there soaking the experience from all these footmen dying. And Hitman, he's fast ERS, by the way, he's just absurd. Like, whenever I had to face this guy a couple times these days in tournaments, Open Cup, WT Champions, like, this guy gives me hell with just one fast here while I know he's leveling his Torrent Chieftain on the other side of the map. Oh, the rifle.
Yeah, that's that could have been caught out. Oh, the wolf almost finds it. Hitman, maybe with a little bit of a misread here, could have done it. He could have killed the Berserker and that rifle if he found Sock earlier at the
time. He might still.
Yeah, he could definitely get some serious kills. He's almost got a chain light. The insta there on the rifle. Oh no, bolt on the wolf. Nice defense there from Sock. But the resummon, can he still secure this kill?
You don't have a chain lighting. There is no dispel. That rifle's gonna dance around. Okay, so these wolves actually end up feeling a little bit of experience here, but the Mountain King still weighs off from level 3. He's just above level 2. On the other side, Torrent Chieftain 3.2. Hitman could actually go for a fight here sometime soon if he wanted to.
Yeah, 45 versus 44, but as you mentioned, the hero level is going to be the big difference maker. Greater heal as well from that mercenary camp. generally you would think, okay, it's daytime, you might need to creep a shop to take a fight to get a potion of vulnerability for the Tauren Chieftain. But because of that greater heal, Hitman might be able to fight even earlier. Sock getting a little bit aggressive. He's got the Pendant of Energy, so plenty of claps, but only on level 1. Speed scroll in, purge to maybe catch a couple rifles out. Stormbolt, but the stomp already lands on both heroes. First rifle goes down, a good start to the fight for Hitman. Town Portal out now.
Sock just can't get anything going here. He doesn't like the way this fight is going, and I can't blame him. Gets out of there. He didn't have Dispel yet. That's the big thing here. Can't right. counter the walls very well. If Lightning Shield was to be used, it would be a disaster, especially on the Tauren Chieftain. I think Hitman waited until he was in a comfortable spot. He saw that Human Army is like, it's really not that big. You don't have that much. I can expand now. Right. Felt safe to do it. And now he's expanding on his side of the map. Of course, the Orc expansion takes a very long time to go up, but if it does from there, Hitman, in my opinion, the absolute best at just getting a lot of units, buying scrolls, and then taking the proper fights.
Absolutely, yeah. Very, very patient when he needs to be. And yeah, there's a double scroll, push and vulnerability, town portal, and sock with really no items. His shop, of course, was, I don't even think, canceled. It was killed earlier when it was constructing. So no double mana pot, and of course, no level 3 Mountain King. He could get it. Could he even get it off? If he's got to go to the shop, he's got to go to maybe one of the labs on the high ground, and Hitman could creep jack. It's almost level 4-4 for Hitman. Sock buys a single mana pot, the illusion. By the way, the expansion was scouted by a militia earlier, yeah. So Sock knows he's on a timer.
Hey, Sock goes there, he's committed though. Or he needs to buy a town portal, but then, you know, canceling the expo and town portaling might not be the best trades. Hitman looking for a fight, that Trucial drop.
Oh my god.
When going Headhunters, the absolute dream here.
Another big fight. Again, no town portal. Sock has the gold to purchase one. Gets Runed Bracers, which isn't honestly a game-winning item that he needs right now. The supply is even, but the expansion is ticking away. It's going to be up in another 30 seconds.
Very unfortunate to get Runed Bracer here for Sock.
For sure. It's
completely useless for the most part. And Hitman's being very patient. I think he knows he has expansion coming up. He doesn't need to rush into a fight. He needs to make sure he doesn't fight creeps plus Sock at the same time. So he's taking his time. Ideally, it'd be the opposite. Militia coming in from behind. That's going to force a fight right now.
Oh, the Lightning Shield, though. Stormbolt on the Tauren Chieftain. The Grunt with the Lightning Shield just absolutely perfectly done by Hitman. He kills every Militia. Level 4. Big stomp there. The Mountain King, though. The Mountain King. GG. Absolute domination. 10 minutes for Hitman.
He didn't lose a single unit in that last fight. It was over before the Mountain King could even reach level 3.
Oh my god.
Fantastic performance here from the American player.
Yeah, did he lose a single unit in the whole game then? Just wolves.
Yeah, he might not have.
Yeah.
Now that you mentioned.
There was nothing killed in the harass either. Is that a first in this tournament?
Is that a perfect?
It might have been. That was a very good game. The perfect defense into the perfect creep out into the two perfect creep jacks. I mean, if he can keep that up, he's going to absolutely dominate Sock, but I don't think. I mean, Sock's going to fight back, absolutely.
Yeah. Hitman showing up strong today. Looking like he's in the right headspace. Honestly, I kind of like seeing him chill earlier in the play area. He was just sitting there listening to music. You know, everybody else is watching the games and chatting, but he's getting in the zone,
for sure.
Right?
Yeah.
I don't know if you saw during the Olympics, Michael Phelps, right? Listening to music and looking a little evil. It wasn't quite on that level, but there was some similarities in that. Like, you know, he had his headphones on and he's just trying to get in the zone, and he looked in the zone here in that game, that's for sure.
Well, Hitman said the first day he was a little bit nervous, actually. He said he didn't feel it initially, but then when he sat down to play in front of the cameras, in front of all the people watching at home, he said he was a little bit nervous. So maybe he's cured his nerves and he's ready to go, because he's looking, I want to say, a lot better than when we first saw him.
Yeah. It's normal to be nervous. It's all about, can you make sure you kind of like push that aside once the game starts and only think about the game?
Absolutely. And Rima Dima's the dude, so I'm thinking about the game. We're going to throw it to the board and see what he's got for us.
Here we have a crucial moment in the game. It was a pretty slow early game. Nothing much of relevance was happening. Bit of a slow tech for Sock, but then he goes for the first time on the aggressive. Burrows were in trouble right away. Hitman had to react fast. They were footmen down here, but with defend. Hard to take out. He's going to realize they're not the right target. Instead, he's going to go for the squishy backline. Right there, perhaps slightly mispositioned by Sock. Hitman sees the opening. Sock played with a Merc Camp start that slowed down his tech, so these mercenaries need to do something for him. But here, perhaps that mistake, and Hitman pouncing on it right away. He sees it. Farseer is gonna go on the chase. 1 second. Gonna go on the chase with a speed scroll. Commits in hard, wants to get these kills, and even if he doesn't get all of them, he knows the push is gonna be over. Beautiful chase by Hitman, beautiful kills, That Berserker does get away, but he got some good experience here, and now the Footman, pretty easy to clean up. He's going to clean up this whole attack, and then he's going to have that big lead to take it to the late game. And Hitman doesn't slip up. He takes the lead, runs with it. Way stronger heroes. The TC delivers. The MK doesn't quite come online, and that's how he wins map one. And now, for a second.
All right, thank you, Mr. Demo Remo Rimmelman. I think I got his last name right. Thank you very much. And yeah, absolutely. I think that was a crucial point in the game for sure. Just getting so much experience. You mentioned almost level 4 Farseer after that pressure. And then from there, just snowball, killed all the footmen in the main base.
And also, what a dream for the Tauren Chieftain. You know, like, born into battle is like, what do I even stop? Boom, boom, like, kills a bunch of footies, gets the water elemental wars of experience as well, goes to the expansion. After that, it was 2.6.
Right.
Like, just the absolute dream of a start here for Hitman. I don't take that for granted. I don't think that's going to happen every game. I think we're going to be seeing very different game plans. You know, we were talking about how the Mercenary Camp was standard. I expect more normal games coming up here between these two as opposed to what we just saw.
Absolutely. And now we're going into map number 2. Autumn Leaves. Will the man in the bottom left be able to equalize? It is Sock.
His opponents in the northeast, in the red trunks, playing Orc and representing the US of A, it is Hitman.
All right, I gotta bring it up, though. Gotta bring it up. Do you think there's potential here for a fast expansion on Autumn Leaves from Sock?
Yeah, actually, the question going into these quarterfinals here for me was not if, but more when.
Right.
I do think he's gonna mix in one, maybe even two fast expansion. Usually, it's between this map and Tidehunters, I think, that he likes
right.
to do it on.
Yep. Definitely a possibility. And honestly, at least from Hitman's words, what he says is the best counter to fast expansion is to have that grunt opener and to get level 2 for Chain Lightning before harassing. You would think maybe intuitively the insta harassing would be good, but in fact, having that Chain Lightning, that extra item, that extra mana, very impactful. So Hitman's got the right read if it is an expansion.
And that's the whole point, is to try and counter each other's creep routes, right?
Right.
If you just play standard, if you just always do the exact same thing, players at this level, they're going to realize it, they're going to study you, and they're going to counter you with the perfect creep route and level of aggression that will put you behind. And if you guys are looking to learn how to fast expand in this matchup, Carson's got a show. It's called Theorycraft, and it's amazing.
Thank you, thank you. Yeah,
every
we did
Thursday.
An episode on this. We actually did a lot of episodes on this matchup in particular. It's actually my favorite matchup in the whole game. I love Orc versus human. So much development in the last 6 months ever since Lin showed the headhunter style. So, yeah, we're pulling all the tricks here from both players.
I wonder if we're going to see the air strategy. I think usually that's reserved for Conceal Hill
for
mostly.
Sure.
And also now it's starting to be a little more known. On this map, if Sock doesn't play with a fast expansion, I expect him to just get defend after a few footies. And then the question would be, does he ever play double Sanctum? Yes, if he wants to go for Beastmaster,
yes.
I think.
Right. Yeah, and if I think the early game goes decently for him, like perhaps if he got that Spirit Lodge cancel, maybe that Burrow kill on Shallow Grave, maybe he just picks up a Beastmaster and goes again right after that to re-cancel the Spirit Lodge. But if he doesn't get any damage done, maybe he transitions
to something else. Oh my god, look at what direction he's going towards here.
Is there a fourth farm?
And there is a Claw on the Farseer, Ring on the Archmage. The grunts, Headhunter, and Wolves are a little late to the party here, but the Farseer will get to work on the Peasants in the main base. That's to weaken the lumber economy of Sock, as to really delay that expansion here. And look what he's going to do. Oh, this is so smart. He's sending the units to the Expo. So he's going to harass the main with the Wolves and the Farseer, make sure that Sock doesn't have enough lumber to comfortably get his expansion plus the Arcane Tower in the main base, and then he's looking to kill Peasants at the Expo, pair up to Vitality. Not the item you're hoping for. You just want pure damage here if you're Sock. And look at those Peasants super exposed. Now Hitman with a hard counter to the creep routes.
Yeah,
score some big snipes here.
Yeah, and he's so close to level 2 as well. A couple of Peasant kills and Chain Lightning in the main base. Sock trying to hold on. He's almost on his way to level 3 with another camp. One more Peasant goes down. A couple more, in fact, 2 more, and then that will be level 2 on the Farseer. The Claws, as you mentioned, going to help out a ton. The tower needs to come up. This is what Sock needs. He'll go for the tower. Then after he's secure and safe, he'll go for the expansion. But all the while, Hitman's teching.
And the main Wolf is trying to take out another Militia. It's going to get sniped before, which feeds a little bit more experience to that Archmage. You want to make sure you don't give him level 3 too early here. And Hitman for now, he has that rogue grunts behind enemy ranks here, kind of attacking on these Peasants. by the expo. For stock, when you go for an expansion, you're always going to lose quite a few peasants. It's all about limiting those losses. And we saw, even though against Soin, he lost so many peasants, he ended up winning that game somehow. So, of course, it's not good that he's losing peasants, but it's, you know, something that comes with the territory when you go for that build order.
Yeah, you're kind of accepting that the game's going to be a little bit messy, and the wolves still clean up more peasants. By the way, two also red HP footmen. The footmen are getting so low, Todd. Is there going to be a shop at any point? There's no shop yet. Almost every footman on the map is dead. Tier 2 almost done. I'm wondering if Hitman, this seems like a panda game. He does prefer Torrent Chieftain against Expo, but I think if ever you're going to go panda, it's
here. He might click on the tunnel.
Absolutely, I think he could. Militia being called from the main right now, by the way. I think just go for the town hall here.
Might go for the peasants. I mean, both seem like a good choice because he's getting experience for the peasants. If you go for the tunnel and you fail and you don't get it, it's quite a bit of a disaster. And he probably knows that militia's already coming in. So many snipes. Fastier is 2.8. Wolves level 2 would be amazing here for him to get. He's just going to kite perfectly against the militia here.
Yeah, a couple more kills and that'll be level 3. Sock obviously well aware of that. No defend in the future at all. It's going to take a long, long time to get that. The militia will soon be peasants. Water elemental summons again. Sock just needs to hold on. As we were just saying, it does get really messy. You're going to take a ton of losses. But if the expansion can be secured, you can tower up and you can hold eventually.
Yeah, these militia were way too far out. I'm surprised he chased this far. This is a big mistake because now peasants are very slow. They are more exposed. They go from having armor to having zero once they turn into peasant mode. And he somehow gets Fastier 3 before the Archmage does. Great deny, actually. That would have been Archmage level 3 here.
Oh my god, yeah, that's such a sick deny. He can't have known. It just goes for it anyway, and he's going to deny that. Now Panda as well, the split push yet again. Just like a human mirror, this is theming like the attack on two sides. But eventually Hitman will have to go back. Troll Regen going to kick in at the perfect time. Another, is that level 3? He does get that Headhunter. Perhaps a little mistake there from Hitman.
Yeah, it could have been denied probably. I think he was hoping that he would escape, but it kind of got caught up too. Hitman behind this. How aggressive does he want to play? There is no Lodge here. He just went for the Bestiary. He has a second Bestiary, so he's going to counter it the same way we saw Soin try to play against this. You can go for Raiders, Pillage, keep attacking that one expansion, and that's going to be for Sock to try and build a perfect wall, not just in the expansion, but also in the main to make sure that Tunnel doesn't take too much damage and feed a lot of gold to those Raiders.
Oh, Breath, Wolves. The Arcane Tower is great against the Wolves, of course, but there's still going to be a lot of Peasants going down. Militia called. No defense still in sight. And soon enough, there's going to be Raiders coming out. Militia are actually wisely defending the Wolves. That's an excellent choice from Sock. And he seems to be holding on. There's not another Breath quite yet. And some Headhunters are also getting low. The Militia again. Hopefully this time they don't chase too far. Resummon of Wolves, that's a big upgrade for Hitman.
He's going for a Wind Rider first, not Raider.
Maybe to the main base? There was an Arcane in the main.
Yeah. An Arcane, it's not the greatest against Wind Riders, but it will. It's enough to do some damage and eventually push them back. I wonder if he might try to kill the tower very quick, because you know he sees that there is no guard towers.
Yeah.
And why would there be, right? You're supposed to count on footmen and I guess Water Elemental, the Archmage, and your Arcane Tower to kind of defend against Headhunters, right? You wouldn't necessarily add... Oh no, there's no tower in the main.
There's no tower. There's a Lumber Mill on the way. More peasants going down. The Wind Riders are soon going to be flying across the map. Almost all but one peasant go down. Sock, maybe going to find some kills. Boots of Speed could be excellent for the Archmage, but it's daytime and the shop is not crept now. Panda level 2. Sock, I don't really see an out for him. He's calling Militia for the third or fourth time. And
can you hear it,
more peasants
from across the ocean? USA. USA. He's doing it right now. Hitman finding kills left and right. Sock down to 30 supply here. He's chasing so far out again with the Militia. All of them are going to die. The Headhunters kiting away. They're surviving with red hit points. All of them. The Archmage is not really low as well.
There's a shop up for Sock. There's no tech as well. Still no defend. This expansion might just be dead. Can Sock come back somehow on one base? Another Wind Rider on the way. A tower being upgraded in the main. A guard at that. More militia coming across. But more peasants are dying. You keeping track? I think this is about 15 this game already or something.
Yeah, a lot of them have fallen, that is for sure. Footman as well. Archmage comes back in. Actually, he's low. And the regen scroll was canceled. And that's it. For game number 2, Hitman, with another masterful performance. He definitely lost some units there, but he wasn't even that many.
No, not at all. I think maybe 3 Headhunters, one of which was denied. And that's a very quick 2-0. Wow, didn't think it was going to go this way. We thought it was going to be one-sided because we're cursed. Yeah, but I mean, didn't think it would go in that direction. Wow. Sock needs to reverse sweep. Can he do that? Absolutely. He's one of the greatest players in the world, one of the greatest human players in the world. but it's going to be difficult for anyone, regardless of how good they are.
Hitman is in the zone. I want his playlist. I want to know what he was listening to here before he played those games, because right now he's running this show. And that counter was beautiful, by the way. Like, you can tell how much research he's done into countering this type of build.
Yeah.
Let's say he would go to the expansion with everything. It's so much easier for Sock to first kill the creeps and then deal with the units that are there. But now his lumber economy was under siege the entire game. Peasants started falling left and right. And he always targeted the right thing. Sometimes I even thought he should maybe go for the town hall, but I think he was right to go for the peasants at the expo instead.
Absolutely, yeah. Maybe he would have lost a bit too much HP. And yeah, that just shows right there why fast expansion is sometimes not the most desirable strategy for human. I think we saw it in spades there, and we saw peasant deaths in spades there as well. But I believe we're going to go into a short break, and we'll be back for map number 3. And we're back with potentially the last map of the day. I can't believe I'm saying that. The question is, can Sock strike back? Can he reverse sweep the American? Didn't expect this, Todd.
You know, that's how it goes. You do well against someone on ladder, then you go to a tournament, yeah, and then they smack you around. This happened to me so many times. It might be happening to Sock here. He needs to find some momentum, and perhaps this would be the map to do it on here, as we're going to be playing on Last Refuge in the bottom left-hand side of the map, playing as the Orc in the red from the US of A. It is Hitman.
And in the upper right, if he has any tricks up his sleeves, he better pull them out right now. It is Sock. All right. Hey, Todd.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light.
No POTUS. Lines?
POTUS. Get the invite ready, because this guy's going to the White House after he ships this tournament. I tell you that.
Okay. Yeah, we're straight through the front door, right out the back. Okay, Last Refuge. What might we see here?
It's a lot about doing a regular creep route in the start, I think, for Sock, and trying to get that Troll Priest, which Hitman is very good at blocking, but seems to be under the impression that it cannot be prevented.
Right.
Which I'm not sure is the case. I really think it's about what can the peon make happen as it's really about to die. Small chance of a fast expansion,
yep,
especially if he's able to get a Troll Priest. But that's going to be the real challenge here in the start. And I'm not seeing Hitman send a peon out yet. So, I mean, I hope he goes for that block, because it's very important to do so. What do you make of the building placement? He just wants to reinforce quicker into the map, right, with that barracks placement.
Yeah, the cool thing about this placement is generally your grunt is a little bit far behind when you go for that priest first, so you have to wait unless it gets ensnared. Or, yeah, it gets ensnared if you're there too quickly. So the grunt coming out of the barracks there, they'll actually be there at the same time, so we can just start creeping that priest immediately.
Oh.
Very optimized. Also, the burrow, the peons were going into the burrow and coming out of the burrow to give a little bit more lumber. Hitman extremely optimized, looking very confident.
And Hitman didn't block at all on the mercenary camp, and Sock is opening up with that mercenary camp up first here, so he's going to have the Troll Priest instantly. There was no glitching of that camp here achieved by Hitman. He's not going there at all.
Does he really just not care? I don't think Hitman's the type of player to not cover this option. Maybe he thinks, like, it's all right, I can creep the priest.
I think this is so much better for Sock right now.
Yeah, it has to be. It has to be. He's going to have the priest. He's going to have a ton of experience.
Oh my god, he got two shots.
Excellent start for Sock.
I mean, you can just get a farm there, pull back, do one of the small green camps, either the Murloc or the Ogre. And then, well, I guess, double Tome of Strength. There goes that HP. Archimage not so squishy anymore now, is he?
It's going to be level 2 eventually for the Farseer, but the green camp will go to Sock as well. And okay, now Hitman realizes it. Wolves resummoned. And maybe what Hitman thinks is, if he gets that priest, I can't do anything anyway, might as well back up and creep. But of course,
yeah,
as you mentioned, he could have just probably prevented the mercenary creep in the first place.
Yeah, I think if he would have just rushed there, he could just target some peasants, maybe kill some of them. He would have made it very hard for Sock to be fighting the mercenary camp plus his opponent at the same time. Now the question is...
Expo, I think.
He starts defense!
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. Very unorthodox play from Sock. An adjustment made from map 2. Now he's getting defend and then going for the expansion. And that, honestly, the footman getting damaged so much is really what hurt Sock on Autumn Leaves. So.
And Hitman knows about this. He's going to show up. He needs to steal some of these creeps here, because Archmage 2.7, if he could prevent somehow level 3, he's going to try to get a steal. with just an auto attack, he doesn't get either. And that's Archmage level 3 already, even before the Magi dies, which might force a Chain Lightning onto that. No, he doesn't even go for it. He's going for the units purely here. Troll Priest is down. Now Wolves can be summoned. That was so well done, actually, the delaying of the summoning of those Wolves. But defense already finished. This is madness, Carson.
Yeah, very, very important. That Grunt and that the Wolves now in the Fire Spirit are the only things that can really damage the Footmen. But the Headerns are going to go for the Peasants in the Tower. Of course, there's enough Headerns to just cancel that Arcane straight up. Chain Lightning is excellent, but the Fire Spirit takes a lot of damage. He has a Replenishment Potion, but the Defend will make this so much easier for Sock. Wolf chasing around the Berserker. Tier 2, about 80% done. Shop on the way for Hitman. But Sock, this is a much better expansion attempt from the last game.
Oh, yeah. He's 3.3. He has some extra attack speed. True shots for any Water Elemental Mercenaries that he's going to have here. Do you think that the only counter to this is like with one or two Bestiary, or don't you think maybe he could, like the Expo is quite delayed, right?
Right.
Couldn't he go for like a Lodge and then Expo himself?
I think so. We could definitely see a Torn Chieftain counter expansion here. Hitman's done that in the past. You control the map, you try to steal away creep camps.
Ooh, nice deny.
Yeah, nice deny there for sure. Denying at least a level 4 in the future. The Burrow is very much exposed. If the Water Elemental's not focused on, definitely get this cancel. And in fact, I think he will. But the Tier 2 is about to be done.
Yeah, Hitman on 29 out of 31.
Oh, wait, that's the Torn Chieftain Burrow that just got canceled. He forgot about it. Very unfortunate.
Yeah, actually, if he loses one more Headhunter, I guess cup half full, he could start his second hero. But yeah, you obviously don't want that. He's trying to go for the chase with another Spin Scroll onto the Mercenaries here. Will be able to get the Troll Priest. A bit more experience gained through that, but the Berserker actually ran past all those Headhunters to attack right back into this one Burrow here and the units that are there.
And this is all gravy here for Sock. He's going to lose a couple of units, sure, but his expansion is free. And, okay, he's only now getting the Town Hall, actually.
Hitman has 4 free supply. 4. You need 5 to make the second hero.
Yeah, that Burrow being late was very rough, or else he maybe, don't want to say he could pick up a Panda, but he could have started the Torn Chieftain. He's getting a lot of kills, but not level 3 Farseer that we saw last game. Some Footmen could feed enough experience. Another Headhunter definitely going to go down to the Archmage. Could be denied. Won't actually even need to be. Nice micro from Hitman and a low damage roll, I believe, from the Archmage.
Lodge starting now right behind the Burrows. The nerves on Sock to actually go for an expansion after being down 0-2, by the way.
Yeah.
This guy does not feel pressure. Another Grunt goes down. That's Archmage 3.7. If you thought that level 3 Archmage is scary, wait until you see him on level 4 with even more Water Elementals, or Water Torrents, as we call them.
Yeah, this is going to be an excellent carry for the game. Speed Scroll away just to save those Headhunters. Finally, a Torrent Chieftain coming out. It could have already been on the field and probably would have saved that Grunt for Hitman. Lodge is up, though. Nothing really canceled other than that Burrow. And the expansion was quite late. In fact, yeah. It only finished a little while ago, has only mined 150 gold off of it. And Hitman now scouts that as well. The tech for Sock. Where is it? It's not anytime soon, but he's got enough peasants on Lumber back at home.
Sock has saved a lot on low hit points. Look at this. There's 2 footmen here right below this. There's 2 more and the Berserker on half hit points. So that regen scroll value here is going to be absolutely insane. The Water Elemental down there will get a cancel perhaps on the Bestiary here. Is that enough damage? There's still a decent amount of time left on its one footman probes forward here. Needs to activate defense.
That Water Elemental very well could get that Bestiary canceled. The Torn Chieftain's just idle. He could definitely stomp the Water Elemental. Okay, he will save the Bestiary with a stomp here. I think the Farseer is trying to pressure, and then I imagine Hitman will try to creep his. He's actually not going for the stomp of the Water Elemental? I think there's no way he calculated this. He can't know the Water Elemental will expire. Oh my god, okay, he saves the Bestiary.
He can indeed eat it, Carlson.
Unbelievable. So he's got a counter expand now, but Hitman down 14 supply currently, and Muddy now joins the force.
The TC is engaging the Expo alone here before the units are even there. A couple mistakes like this from Hitman.
Yep.
I mean, I can't think this was 100% intentional, because he's going to take so much more damage now than he would have if he had just waited a few seconds for the army to have rejoined that location. So Hitman maybe starting to feel the pressure, you know, like he's up 2-0. This is a $5,000 extra if you get the win here, and you get a chance at so much more in the next round. Then we go from 10,000 to 22,000. So then the next best of 5 win would be plus $12,000 on top of that, and then the one after that.
It's like a game show. It just keeps doubling. Right. Urge could be available. Slow on the Shaman. What an excellent choice with that Mud Golem. So well done. The Shaman dies level 2, and the Torn Chieftain can now stomp to defend that Burrow. No spiked barricades, by the way. Mud Golem is getting so much value. The Priest will get some before he eventually does fall, but the Footmen need to be dealt with back in the main base.
Yeah, reinforced defenses is very close to finishing, but this is still extremely annoying. Sock is ignoring the army completely. He's like, I want that burrow. He's staying there with all the footmen, attacking it the whole time. And in the meantime, Sock went completely around to make sure that there was no expansion on the way. He knew about the possibility of it to be there. Hitman not quite taking the risk just yet. He's probably looking to try and get closer to 50 supply, then take it. But it's just going to be such a late expo that Sock should then be able to go easily into 60, 70 supply and perhaps steamroll with a bigger army here.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the main play for Hitman now is to try to get map control, try to kill some of these units, and not allow that second hero, whether it be a Mountain King, Panda, probably a Mountain King here, not allow that second hero to creep up for Sock. Hitman's got to steal away the shop, maybe even try to steal away his lab and expand behind it. But 1,500 gold just barely for Sock currently. This is going to be a massive tier 2 army.
He's so safe on his side of the map as well. He's got one guard and one arcane on both bases. He's adding one more guard at the expo. That's because you can't have militia there. Starting a Mountain King immediately upon reaching tier 2, and I expect double Sanctum to start momentarily as well. Sometimes even triple there. Like, you just got so much economy, you might as well. And because when your second hero comes out, you want to be creeping, you get even more gold from that. And then you get to 80 easily with scrolls, and that's when the big attack happens.
Snare just now finished, or else the Archmage might have been on the focus fire target of Hitman. And now he's creeping up the Torn Chieftain, but only creeping greens. Really not what he needs to be doing right now, but I honestly don't know the answer to that question myself, what he needs to do to get back in this game. 39 supply currently, 700 gold can soon enough break upkeep once that new burrow finishes. I do believe, he just built the Great Hall. That's where the resources went, and now Hitman probably going to try to pressure the map just to secure that expo. If that expo comes up uncancelled, there might be a slight chance.
You know, in StarCraft 2, when you fall really far behind, like, I think the greatest players, their best way to come back is to let their mechanics speak. And right. That is constant worker production and just great harassment. Really perfect macro combined with good decision making. I think there could be some similarities there. Obviously, it's Warcraft is a different game than StarCraft 2, but I think if Hitman just relies on his fundamentals, his great macro in the fight, good decision making in the mid game, like, he should probably try and engage before there is big supply and then do as much damage as he can, pull back, regroup, start creeping again, and try to build his own big supply army to try and match that of Sock. Obviously, it's going to be really hard because Sock has this insane bank that once he spends, he's going to have a lot, but there is some timings you can go for. Look, right now he knows that he has way more, and Sock can't certainly engage, so he steals the merchant from him and gets a greater healing. The Mountain King deep behind enemy lines. Can he even escape this? He has an invuln, that's it.
Oh, the rifle's exposed. Could be a fight the Hitman wants, but he kind of backs away. A little bit uncertain. I think he can go for this fight if he wants. Chain Lightning, Lightning Shield, Water Elemental Purge. Mountain King doing some work, but he is caught behind enemy lines still.
Got a TC going deep here. Might get Stone Bolted at the perfect timing. It's almost going to go down. Can he use the greater healing before? No! It goes down before that was usable here. Stone Bolt timing perfect from Sock. He knew that there was going to be enough damage to finish that off. And now that has to be an instant revive here from Hitman. And he can't really afford it, to be honest. I mean, it's so expensive. He's having to expand at the same time. It's units that he could have made instead.
Oh my god. This is going to be a 90% expansion cancel coming up. The bolt, so well timed. There was a greater heal. That could have been Hitman's comeback potential. But this expansion now at the bottom, there's no saving it. Sock with an excellent play going around the outside past the red camp. And now he's going to cancel it. And this is looking dire in game 3 for Hitman.
I assume this had to have been Sock's map, right?
It was.
Yeah.
Sock's map, yeah.
It's definitely playing out like it was. TC's almost level 4. I guess that's something that you can start thinking of that maybe is going to be good for Hitman if you can keep on leveling that.
Right.
A workshop on the way here. So maybe he wants to add some mortars to his composition, or maybe it's just in case he thinks he's going to be weaker against Wind Riders, but I have to think maybe Maltars against this many Shamans and, you know, the Kodo as well.
Right, yeah. And there's a decent amount of rifles as well. So Sock TP's to his expansion, and he's going to creep, I think, the wisest camps possible. He still doesn't necessarily have map control. He's waiting on a round of production before he has a supply advantage. So he's going to get the level 3 Mountain King just creeping, honestly, kind of passive, the most passive camp on the map, despite it being very difficult to creep, of course. So Hitman's going to get the majority of the map, but the supply is going to tell a different story. This is going to be 50 against 70 in no time.
Yeah, Sock is doing the right thing here. You definitely want to get your second hero to level 3 before you go back and engage. It is supposed to be clap level 2, I think, yeah. I don't see much upsides to getting Bolt level 2 here. But you might still have to Bolt the TC, so maybe perhaps you might still go for that. But yeah, Hitman, the supply is not that far apart right now. It's 50 to 67. It's starting to get a little bit of out of control, so he's going to try and force another fight. Catching off reinforcement here. That one Breaker gets caught. He's also trying to force the Town Portal, against which he can just even run away or try and fight and then speed scroll if it gets too dicey as well.
Yeah, but absolutely.
That would be with Militia here because he's close to the main base, so usually ends up with the Orc Bear ejecting. Endurance was picked up on the Mountain King. Great item here for Sock.
Yeah, what is Sock doing? Sock, I feel like he needs to defend. He's losing a ton. He's going for the expansion cancel, and he will probably get it, but he's going to lose every peasant in the main base. Is this worth it, Todd?
I feel like he should have TP'd because as long as he gets 80 and he then attacks. By the way, Sock is out of 100. Yeah. That guy way overmade farms.
Yeah, he made
what
a ton of farms.
This?
Yeah. Okay, main base. Now he's going to TP. TPs will be exchanged. Maybe a shaman could be sniped. No, defensive town portal, of course, because of the stomp. But you how many corpses? My God.
You know what it is? Like, he wanted to build a wall around the expo in main in case he got siege. So he made, like, so many farms.
Yeah. Yeah, 100. I think he's even got more than he needs because he was at 90 earlier and then he made a bunch more. So, yeah, two peasants in the main just building towers and we're back to even economy. But
and TC is close to 5 now.
Oh my God.
Give this guy an invis potion right in the middle of the army. Boom, open with a stomp. The dream's alive, I feel, for Hitman.
And he gets whatever he got, he sold it. Okay. Didn't quite. Oh, potion vulnerability on the ground. Very safe. Tauren Chieftain. And double heal scroll, no town portal for either player.
Oh, he still has his lab. But I think he knows that he understands the movement perfectly. He's like, Sock's going to be in the middle, probably going to my expo if I get my lab, so I'm not going to do that. Instead, I'll go there and meet him. He's kept Sock low on supply through his movement. This is what I was talking about earlier. Just great decision making throughout, but now it's still 48 supply to 69. That great number. And Sock perhaps willing to accept the fight here in a second. He's got clap level 2 Archmage at the front. Mountain King kind of stuck behind. Stormbolt is dodged here. He's going to go for the Archmage to try and force the Town Portal.
He's got to be careful, Sock. He cannot milk the TP. There he goes for it. Yeah, if there's another stomp and there was no Town Portal, that would have gone down. And a lot of unit kills. Nice clap at the end. So a TP traded for, I guess, just a grunt there. But the salves do cost. And Sock going to go right out on the map yet again. This time with no TP, though. His bank is not there, but he has a 20 supply advantage still.
Okay, Wolves probably shouldn't be there. I don't see control magic being researched yet. It just starts now, so Sock realized he kind of forgot that. He could have still stolen those two wolves and been really annoying with them.
Yep.
The problem for Hitman about fighting in center like this is that he needed to run home immediately after to get... Wait, how did he get 5? He just got 5, right?
Did Kodo devour, maybe?
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God, because he was 4.9. So that's great, actually, being able to open up the fight with this. With an invis pot would have been even better, but I think the priority was to use Clarities here because he really needed mana for that upcoming fight. All right, Hitman. If he's able to defend this and save the expo, might be able to do it, but it's going to be so hard. There is so much supply with Breakers. Again, dodges the opening Storm Bolts, but Sock immediately runs away.
Triple Priest surround. There's no Town Portal to be passed. Sock, I don't think Sock should hold that expansion. Or that expansion. The surround. A clap is big again. Plenty of mana, but there's no mana potion. Can the next stomp be big? No, the Breaker Wall is excellent. The feedback comes in, and the stomp cannot land yet again. Maybe with that mana pot he can.
Oh, did you see? Is he stuck? He barely wiggles out of there. I don't know if he can get out, though. There is about to be a Stormbolt very soon. Comes back in. The mana on the Mountain King. 70 right now. 71. 75. Does he go for the Stormbolt? No, the TC is too far. Sock can't quite make up his mind. He's doing fine against the army now. Might not need to Stormbolt anything. Goes for the Kodo to free that one Breaker. And Sock takes a massive supply lead here. It took some time, but he finally made the push happen. And Hitman in a world of trouble. Goes for Shane Lightning level 3, as should you here.
Mana pot, heal, salve, the expansion's still standing in the Mountain King. Not a ton of mana, but the level 3 now aura working overtime. If the stomp is big, maybe there's a kind of a chance, maybe only chances to force a town portal though, but there's a potion of vulnerability on both heroes. Gonna be very, very difficult. Sock is pressing forward, almost 80 supply even. Gonna probably kill the Farseer here. This is definitely looking like a map number 4.
DC coming in. Lightning Shield, Chain Lightning level 3 here onto the Mountain King. Should be able to get back. There is quite a few priests here to try and keep everything alive. And Sock decisive here. That True Shot pickup, absolutely insane this whole game. Not just in the start with the Weather Elementals, but right now everything that he has is ranged. Literally everything. He doesn't have a single meta unit except for that one Mountain King, which I don't think he minds.
Yeah. Definitely not at all. The auras are doing great, and the expansion is not so much. It is dead yet again. Double the supply for Sock currently. Yes, some of it's in workers, but most of it is in this army we see right now. And this is going to be near impossible for Hitman without maybe an Archmage kill. I think that's it. I think that's all he can do.
I think even then, he'd probably lose his entire army to do it. I think a move command from Sock straight into the back of the main base of Hitman might be the one way that's...
Has happened before. Not for Sock, but I've seen it.
Yeah.
I've done it.
Yeah?
Yeah. Never know.
I did it in StarCraft 2, but never in WoW 3.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Like mass Colossus. I move commanded into a Terran army and EMPs.
Oh, Jesus.
I think I must have killed nothing. I like my army if I put, by the time I realized it was too late.
It does happen to the best of us, apparently. A player's forces are five.
Deep
five.
In a tournament as well.
Oh, Jesus. That's why you remember it so clearly. Bit of cunning. Okay, so more mana. Can't complain with that. The orcs can definitely complain with Mountain King level 5, though, Todd, and that's going to be a reality very, very soon.
The Hitman, props to him with his fighting spirit here, staying in there, but I just don't see how he wins this against Sock. Really playing it carefully here. Taking his time, grabbing two more scrolls. He has two invulns on the Archmage and one on the Mountain King.
Very important to keep those heroes alive, of course. And Hitman's found a couple of opportunities. This level 5 for the Mountain King, Town Portal back. He's found a couple of opportunities to try to come back, but just couldn't close it out. TP. Now can Hitman fight? He's almost has to. There's the first Stormbolt. This clap is going to be pretty huge, and it is indeed, and the army is just not able to fight.
Yeah, the clap is going to hurt everything perfectly here. It's so hard for the TC to actually do much against this many breakers. He just gets bolts and targeted, goes down extremely quickly. Hitman trying to disengage because he was able to devour some units, but Stormbolt will allow Sock to chase thanks to his positioning and movement as well. And that must be it here.
And GG is called now. 2-1 still for Hitman, but Sock definitely equalized in dominant fashion with a strategy we thought maybe not possible after game number 2, but Sock proves yet again it can be strong. You just have to hold on. I really like the defend before the expansion attempt. And of course, mercenary camps help out a ton as well. So a nice adjustments into game 3 from Sock.
Do you think the invitation letter to the White House is being reconsidered right now, or
yeah,
has he still got it?
I think Biden won him a 3-0. All right, some replays here. Yeah, this is when the harass first began in the TC. Well, was denied for quite a while. The stomp. This is really where Hitman had no chance anymore. If he landed that stomp, gets the greater heal off, of course, he would have had maybe a slight chance.
Yeah, he could have transferred TP after that, then it just killed a lot through one more stomp and lightning shell, I think.
Absolutely,
that would have been the dream.
And then here was a little bit weird from Sock, but it worked out. He got so many expansion cancels. His map movement was great with getting those cancels. And this fight looks almost kind of possible, but that TC needs full health and a potion of invulnerability to probably make it happen. Kodo is going to fall, and so many claps after that, and just the hero level is able to carry at the end of the day. And we're going to see what happens on map number 4, but first we're going to take a short break. We'll be right back. And we're back with our last quarterfinal of the day. Hitman match point still, but Sock fighting back on map 3. Now map number 4, Concealed Hill. Could be some interesting strategies from Sock here.
Yeah, that's the map on which Chemiko has been really liking to go for double Griffin Aviary and Air.
Right.
Which I think Hitman should be well aware of, because he was one of the guys that faced it regularly. I watch Chemiko stream quite a bit, and I've seen him do it against Hitman many times. This could be a good map, I think, for Hitman if he's able to figure out what he's facing and he counters it well. So let's get it started in the top right-hand side of the map. In the red trunks, playing Orc and representing the whole NA scene in USA, it is Hitman.
And in the bottom left, representing South Korea, of course, here is Sock. All right, so what would be the telltale sign that he is going to go air? Short of seeing the Castle Tech, Griffin Aviaries, what are some other tells?
usually if you want to go for it, you're playing very aggressive. You're going mount tanking second. As soon as that comes out, you only have footman and water elemental. You're trying to be very aggressive. Catch, you know, whatever shaman's coming out, maybe even target a Tauren Chieftain if he's creeping and he's low.
Yeah.
And you're on the other side of the map being very aggressive. I think that would be a big hint that something's happening. Hitman scouting, though, is like one of the best in the biz. Like, you cannot hide anything against this guy. Whether you go for the main two tech is either Blacksmith or Double Sanctum.
Right.
I think he's never failed to scout me ever. I did, however, recently cancel the Blacksmith and then go Double Sanctum. And then he went Mass Grunts and he didn't go so well against the Sorceresses. So you can trick him, it's just very rare. And I don't think that Sock would be willing to try something like this.
Yeah, we'll see. I doubt he's willing to try an expansion on this map because Field Hill, one of the most difficult expansions in the game, if not the most difficult. And Hitman, fast tech without a barracks. This is new.
Yeah, maybe specific to the map where he didn't feel like opening very quickly with the Grunt and Headhunter would achieve that much. Sock is going for a bit of a greedy creep here.
Yeah.
At the lab, and he's doing this with the version where you get the Scout Tower and Arcane Tower back at home, but the Farseer will be on top of him as he's trying to creep the Rock Golem here. There is some steal potential, and at this level, it's actually not that uncommon to get the steal, which, if it were to happen, if that Farseer gets that Rock Golem here, that would be absolutely amazing for him. Can he get it?
Oh, last hit. Potential, but Sock does secure it. Also gets Scroll the Beast. Could be excellent later on, but he's going to hope for some healing items soon enough. Hitman always prioritizing damage on the Archmage. Going to clean up a couple of the peasants. But the question is, do you chase the peasants now, or do you chase the Archmage and the footmen?
I think the peasants and the Archmage, yeah, you kind of want to ignore the footmen because they can be healed at the fountain easily. Of course, you could wake up the creep sometime with walls. That's like one of the really nice moves you can do. Look at where the footmen went. They went to the top left, maybe to do the green there on their own and then heal up at the fountain.
Right.
So Sock might do two camps at the same time, the same camp on both sides. Here with the Archmage, okay, don't tank more damage, that would be pretty bad.
Yeah, don't get bashed there. Please don't get bashed.
The tech difference is going to be massive, by the way. We have literally the fastest tech possible by Hitman, and we have one of the slowest possible on the other side. Hitman's tech's almost finished. Sock hasn't started, and he killed peasants that have to be replaced.
That's actually kind of brilliant because that means the tier 2 is going to be done by the time Sock wants to harass with the level 3. It's almost a counter to this creep route from Sock.
I think he knew. I think Hitman knew that this was likely to happen, and that's how he wanted to counter it. Like, I think I talked to him about this not long ago, and he was telling me, like, this is one of the creep routes that the Korean players do often, and that is pretty good. So I think he was expecting it. He's just a genius.
Sock will get level 3 here. Yeah, he should. And the grunt comes in now. That's some nice normal damage for the hero armor of the Archmage. More pests is going to go down. That's not level 3 yet. And another one's going to be killed. This is great delay. If you can delay it all when Sock's being this greedy, he's still tier 1, Todd.
He just got enough lumber to start his tech, but he's getting one more peasant because he feels he doesn't have enough peasants on lumber. Unless he wants to plan too fast. He wants to plan too fast expand. Like, this doesn't make much chance to delay the tech this much. Look, he's still not starting the tech. Okay, there it is. Oh my god. The TC is 30%, Carson. And the keep only now starts.
Jesus. And the Archmage still isn't level 3. He's going to clean up the rest of that orange camp and get it, but the tier 2 might be done by the time the Archmage gets there.
In the past, when I've seen this kind of build where you like do a greedy creep like this, you rely entirely on your Archmage level 3 to make up for the disadvantage. So basically now he has to cancel the Lodge. Maybe the Bestiary as well. But the Lodge is placed in a perfect spot by Hitman. Look at this. It's in the top right, protected by Burrows. He's going to lose his Bestiary. He's probably thinking, I don't even care one bit. I just want the Lodge to counter Water Elementals because they're the only thing that you're going to have going for you in this game. Nothing else. There is somehow enough room at the back for the TC to go through. If he stomps now, might be able to save the Burrow. He's repairing with everything that he's got. The Archmage is chased away.
Oh, Scroll the Beast is going to actually get that Burrow kill. And we'll see how many footmen Hitman can clean up. Of course, he's still massively ahead in tech, but the Bestiary and the Burrow going down is going to make the production definitely difficult. The fountains are still open for business for quite a while longer, so Sock's going to be able to heal up both that Archmage that was within the kill threshold of Chain Lightning and all those footmen. So, yeah, not bad at all for Sock here. This is a great early game despite the tech disadvantage.
Yeah, he finally found some damage. Great play by Hitman waking up the creeps at the fountain here as we see the attack again. I think it was the right prioritization here by Sock. He went for the Bestiary at the front, then went for the Burrow. I don't think He could have shot for the Lodge. It was too risky. Like, if you don't get it, you're in too much trouble.
Yep.
And then he ejected at the perfect time. But now Hitman, he creeps his Thorn Chieftain a little bit. If he goes to creep the expansion next and takes it immediately, yep, I think he's going to be in a fantastic spot in this game.
Yeah, haven't seen any Blacksmith yet from Sock, so we'll have to keep an eye if it's Double Sanctum or if he goes for Tier 3. It could be a possibility, yeah, absolutely.
Sock,
11
by the way,
or gold.
Extremely good at surrounds.
Right.
Like, stay away. Don't get... No, 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 no. Run, run, run! Oh, my God.
Oh.
The moment I say that as well, like, he stops.
He still has plenty of opportunity. Ducking, diving, jiving, and he gets out.
Oh, my God.
Just barely. Nice Farseer movement.
What's that show, American Ninja Warrior or something? Can we send that Farseer there? Because I'm pretty sure he's going to win instantly.
Oh, another attempt.
He's playing with fire now. He's actually playing with fire. This is ridiculous.
Beastmaster
second. It finally comes into play. So it should be a double Sanctum here with this.
He's going tier 3. He's going tier 3 behind the Beastmaster.
Oh, my God.
What the? This is brand new. I've never seen this in my life. Combination of two strategies, and Sock continues to pressure.
Nice repositioning here with the Headhunter. TC at the front. Farseer taking a lot of damage. Needs to be careful, that Archmage. Going deep for some of this damage. Still being damaged himself. Needs to fill the burrows up. This is pre-having enough shamans to really deal very well with the water elementals. That's what's to make it tricky. Gets the deny at the front on the grunt. Oh my God, Hitman is so damn good. But so is Sock here with this attack. Finding the right timing, but wasn't able to achieve much.
Yeah, he traded some units, but of course that's totally fine. I mean, trading units is good. Hitman's heroes are going to scale a lot better with this Beastmaster.
Yeah.
Is Sock trying to, like, fake and Hitman maybe not going to scout and say, okay, he's going two Sanctums, and then out of nowhere, boom, Griffins, but already a Windrider, which is standard against Sanctums as well from Hitman, but let's see if he sends a Wolf, I suppose.
It's very well disguised right now. Like, if I was Hitman, I'd be thinking, this is double Sanctum. Like, who goes air with a Beastmaster second?
Right.
So we'll see if he scouts. Obviously, you want to see that this is happening ideally, so you can choose how you want to counter. He obviously has some Headhunters already, but then, you know, do you want to add Batriders to your composition here to try and deal with this properly? Usually, I guess that'd be the main choice.
Windrider!
Windrider!
Oh,
my God.
Oh, no. Oh, no. I swear
he attacked it himself.
Yeah, he was attacking it himself.
He wants to handicap. This is too easy, Carter.
Unbelievable. That's quite a big mistake, but a bigger mistake could, of course, not be scouting those Griffin aviaries. Almost level 3-3. A tell could be from Sock that he's being so aggressive. Generally, he'll back up, creep level 3 Beastmaster, and go for that expansion.
Yeah, this follow-up almost makes it obvious now.
Yeah.
You see, like, two footmen and two heroes. You're like, what is this? Like, you should have, you know, your first few casters, at least a few more footmen. Like, where is all your gold going into?
Hitman playing... really scared, honestly. Maybe he's a little shooken after killing his own Windrider. He could have maybe just turned and gone for the hero folks with Stomp there. But, Bear going to feed a little bit more experience. I believe I heard a Peon die as well, potentially. Yeah, one Peon died to the Bear.
Great here, Carson.
Oh, yeah.
Great catch. So Griffin production will now start. And Sock, because he stopped making footmen a while back, he actually has quite a bit of gold. Look, he starts at 2 Griffin, and he still has enough gold to perhaps even get a Paladin very soon and queue more Griffins. And I think Blacksmith should be in the pipeline as well as something that he adds.
Right.
And just in case there's Batriders, he can go for armor upgrades. Animal War Training going to be very important. Staff going to come in handy as well. And Paladin does start now. He's finding damage because Hitman didn't really respect that follow-up. He's actually going to Temple. Hitman really wanted to clear out that Expo. So he TPs, but the human heroes run away. Footmen will fall, as will those water elementals. So that's a bit of extra experience, but the damage was there here with that burrow snipe.
Yeah, level 1 Beastmaster still, and a Paladin on the way. I'm wondering if the Griffins are going to be enough of a surprise. Hitman, of course, still hasn't scouted it. Getting reinforced defenses, so that means the harass won't be great after this. But
As long as he doesn't stop messing grunts, like, I'm okay with this.
Yeah.
But obviously... he has no idea that his opponent is messing, you know, a very strong unit in the Griffin. He might get to find out when there is number 3 and 4 being produced. That's always going to be very scary.
Yep. Okay, Torn Chieftain on his way to level 4. Bears continue to harass. And Fountain.
This bear is so obnoxious.
He's constantly sending it over and over again. Could be a Witch Doctor, but of course there's no Invis, which is the normal play. The Griffin's excellent at creeping. And even better, they can attack that Red Drake as well, so some nice items could be found. Armor would be the best. Lionhorn is what he wants to protect against the potential Batriders, but of course, he could always have the aura on the Paladin too, so Flute, even better.
Yeah, Griffin is really the highest damage unit to creep with, like, very quickly. So once you start having a few of them, even though it's a map on which the creeps are really tough, you can just start leveling up very, very steadily and work on your composition a little more in terms of if you want to make something different. Like, if there were Batriders, you'd add Dragonhawks, but right. Here he knows that there's not going to be any, so he's just going to be pure Griffin. Not even going to get a single knight, perhaps. And he's getting Storm Hammers as well. Animal War is going to be important. And he definitely should start that very soon for the extra hit points on those Griffins.
Yeah, the bear gave away the positioning of the army for Sock, and Hitman now sees the Griffins. What's the reaction? Immediate Raider Headhunter. So obviously he only sees it now, or else he would have been building that Headhunter earlier.
Yeah.
So he's got his expansion up. I think if he just threatens to take a fight right now, his expansion will be safe. Ensnare Paladin, there's a Staff of Sanctuary available, and it will be used immediately. Sock not messing around here.
And you might think, why not go Mass Batriders with two Bestiaries? But the thing is, there is going to be some armor upgrades being researched eventually there. He started it, then he canceled it because he didn't have the lumber, so he wanted to get Animal War training for the extra HPs first. And more importantly, Devotion Aura. That's actually amazing when you go for many Griffins like this. So if he gets Devotion, like, let's say level 1 or 2, plus level 3 armor, I mean, Batriders, they're just not cost-effective anymore to counter this kind of army.
Yeah, absolutely. It could also be a Protection Scroll. Yeah, Batriders do 500 damage, but if there's any armor, that does reduce the damage. So sometimes even Inner Fire, Protection Scroll, Devotion Aura, 0-3, it takes about 24 Batriders to kill a single Griffin. That has happened to me in the past on Melting Valley. You might have some fond memories of that map, Todd.
Yeah, loved it. Should come back in a pool.
All right, another red camp crept out, this time for Hitman.
This true shot is really big, by the way.
Yeah.
Every Griffin has plus 4, so 45, 55 damage, plus 4. They have Devotion now as well. And, I mean, TC is an important hero, but he's very good against ground, not so much against air here, right, which is the whole point of this strategy.
Yeah, that's why we're going to see Hitman go for a lot of Raiders. He's getting a Batrider. He's already got 3 Raiders because you can ensnare and then stomp the Griffins. That's a decent way to deal with them, and it does stun them. So he's going to try to go for that, but of course, you know, the levels don't really matter if you can only ensnare 3.
I think they're going to clash at the fountain.
Right.
Because there is an illusion they are scouting, and that's where Hitman should go next. Sock actually being very conservative, running home right now. Maybe he wants to grab another staff. Maybe he knows that Hitman should be on the right-hand side about to fight him, and he's not ready to take the fight just yet because he's only on 50 supply, so we'll see. He's getting Iron Forged Sword, so the plus 1 attack. So he's not going into more armor upgrades just yet. He just made the plus 1 earlier. Maybe he didn't have quite enough lumber. No, he queued it in the blacksmith after the plus 1 attack.
It's Hitman going into the main base. This would be a perfect timing. He knows that Sock isn't creeping the fountain, so therefore he must be pushing the expansion. This is just the perfect timing from Hitman. He might be suicided the expansion, but he could always do the damage and TP out.
It's 5 Griffins and 1 Dragonhawk, plus the tri-hero of human. Oh my god, that stomp into the peasants! He's doing so much damage. He has a lightning shield as well. Peasants are gonna fall very rapidly. The army on the other side is gonna take a while to kill out the expansion. Sock is underestimating this attack here. He's killing... I mean, he's losing so many peasants and not really killing that much on the other side. I mean, peons are going down, but the expo... Hitman might just TP now and be totally fine, but Sock town portals first. Wait, Hitman's gonna take the fight? No, he TPs out. TC's a little far. Torrent Chieftain is so far, he's not going to TP.
No, the TC doesn't get out. There's no Stormbolt, though.
Yeah.
That we've seen that mistake so many times in this tournament. That's the third time. If there was a Mountain King there, that could have easily been the game.
And TC gets level 5 here.
Oh, my God.
Farseer almost level 5 as well. That will 100% be Chain Lightning level 3 against this air army. At this point, with how much damage he did, Hitman only has to get as many Batriders as he can. I don't care that there's Devotion, I don't care that there's a Scroll and Paladin. He needs to get rid of this air army and then he will have won the game. And here we see the replay of, I guess, the Peasant Song and the Peasant Song. 1-2-3 Peasant, Carson. It's not a Warden this time.
Speaking of 1-2-3 Peasants, there's currently only 5 as the 6th comes out. And that means, importantly, armor upgrades are off the table. Oh, he's getting the second armor upgrade. That's going to be the last of the lumber. Oh, he got a Shredder. Okay, that's going to help out a ton. Or was that Hitman Shredder? I just heard one. I imagine Sock might have gotten one. Okay, it was Hitman.
Dude, there's still a bear in the peon line.
Oh my god.
This is the most obnoxious harass I've seen in the wild, but he's feeding experience. Wait, Farseer is 4.9. Oh my. This Farseer just needs a little bit more XP.
No
get
TP.
Chain Lightning level 3.
The shop was killed earlier. Of course, there's not going to be gold for a town portal. This could be the last fight. Can Sock do something here?
And snares the Dragon Hawk immediately, so there's no shackle available. Blows up all of the griffins, but three, all of them are ensnared, except for, actually, two of them are not. But Stomp is disabling the heroes. Can the Headhunters deal with the air army? It looks like it.
Hitman's about to kill everything. The Stomp on the Archmage. There's no TP. He's about to kill one of the last griffins. The Paladin is trying to save the units, but there's nothing to be saved. 33 versus 44. The expansion lives. The griffin falls. Is Hitman really winning 3-1, Todd? Can he do it right here, right now?
He may be doing it for America, Carson. He's on the chase now. Beastmaster low. Still no town pole on the Archmage. Sock needs to evacuate here. He needs to buy a town pole and get out of there. Griffin gets staffed, but it needs no staff for his hero. He's still got another one on the Beastmaster. Transfers a potion and uses it. Paladin, so close to level 3 as well. That could be Divine Shield level 1 used if he can get that, but he's just trying to eject from that location, just trying to get out. Paladin gets targeted down. Pops the invuln with a transfer at the last seconds. Can he get out with this? Sock still has a chance. He's not that far behind in supply, but he needs to heal up. He needs to regroup and remake a little bit of army before he re-engages, and he gets out of there, Carson.
Oh, double raider. Wondering, did he skill the level 2 Holy Light? Because he's going to need Divine Shield, like you mentioned. Yeah, there's a Divine Shield skill. Okay, he does get out with the Heroes of the Bear again.
Oh,
how many peons this time?
Are you kidding me?
He just never stops, does he? Okay, Hitman, of course, has that Shredder. He's still got enough back at home. And Sock holds on. 46 supply versus 52. The expansion lives as well, but Sock, my God. And now a bear at the expo.
These bears are relentless, man. Well, this one will get purged pretty quickly without doing too much. And those have fed quite a bit of experience.
Right.
Like, we could actually have level 6 heroes on Hitman's side here momentarily. This is the last big camp on the map that's available. Actually, great pickup for Sog, because he's got 50 supply, and Hitman doesn't actually have that much. He's got 58. Sock, if he can get two more units, he might be able to match that supply and take another big fight. I thought this was almost it here. If he had lost any of his heroes, it would have been disastrous.
Yeah.
But he somehow saved everything here.
Yeah, I'm surprised Hitman didn't commit maybe some more Shaman mana. I'm not sure how much he had at the time, but maybe just to really secure that kill. He might have not been able to check all three heroes for the items, but of course the staff was on cooldown, and that was it to get out of there. Still a good
position. He was on the intercept course. He's like, it's not going to get me again with that one. He became animal control, Carson.
Yeah, I think even though there's no invis, he could still get a Witch Doctor just to see the two lanes in which the summons could come down.
Don't you think the game is a little too hectic for that? Like, maybe you're right, actually. Like, that would make his life a whole lot easier if he could see it coming. I kind of feel like Hitman should stand between his main and expo.
Yeah.
Because obviously he's going to be the one on the siege momentarily. Like, he sees that there is no expo. He's scouted consistently with walls. And now Sock is going for the next wave of the attack. He's got two healing scroll and a protection scroll. If he can keep enough of this air alive, he's going to pummel this orc ground army here without tier 3. It's really for the Tauren Chieftain to land some big stomp, disable as much of the ground as possible. And I don't see much Batriders here. It's just the one. There is a critical mass of griffins.
Action scroll, of course, is only purged to get rid of one at a time. Hitman has a supply advantage. Sock is never really going to be able to break up. Keep the Batrider lands. It could be a Holy Light, but still only level 1. Holy Light, Chain Lightning Stomp lands on what it can. The Kodo, the Headhunters are trying to do all the piercing damage they can as well. The Shamans out of nowhere. The expansion's still mining. Are the heroes going to carry for Sock? The Beastmaster may not be the best, but the Griffins may be.
Summons another bear here. Forced back is Hitman with a Speed Scroll. Reengages immediately after. Tauren Chieftain and Fossey, almost level 6, but I don't know if he even changed much here. He just needs to get rid of the air, but it's been so hard with these scrolls, with the Holy Light, with the staffs. Sock running out of mana on the Beastmaster. He's pulling back right now. Paladin still with quite a bit of mana, but remember, he had to go for Divine Shield, I believe, so he should have only Holy Light.
Oh, he retrained, actually. He retrained.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
Oh, that is sick.
Level 2 Holy Light.
Worth, actually. Only 200.
Absolutely. Yeah, back to the fountain. By the way, level 6 Tauren Chieftain doesn't even go for Reincarnation. He goes for Aura, Todd. All right, Hero Focus may be potential, but the Holy Light's going to be so good.
That's smart, actually.
Yeah, I think so. I don't think, and you know, unless Sock checks, he's never going to know there's no ultimate. He's just going to be assuming level 6 now. And no ultimate probably there for the Farseer either.
Even if he
either.
Checks, he's never going to kill that
he's
big bad Tauren Chieftain here. Remember, there is still no Town Portal. He's trying to go for the heroes. Finally, he sees that the Paladin is limited with the mana for the Holy Lights. There's still so many units here. for Hitman, but they're starting to run low. The kiting and repositioning is so great from both players. Two more Griffins come in to try and help out as much as possible, but all of the human heroes are going low. Losing any of them might mean the game here. Paladin being targeted, he has an invuln. He uses that on time, but he's out of mana. He's about to have a Holy Light. Can he save the Beastmaster?
Is there mana for a stomp? Is there a staff? Is there a staff? Can he save the Beastmaster? Holy Light there, last second. Staff out of the Paladin. All the heroes are living and five Griffins in the air, Todd. Is Sock really doing this? The expansion, of course, is mining all the while. Oh, but the Stormhammer's on the entire army of Hitman. Hitman's heroes are doing damage, but the army is just kind of crumbling to the pressure in the air. And Hitman holds the expansion at least, but Sock holds on to this game. Main base is, by the way, about to run
dry. Oh, Esther? Oh my god, he scares! He uses Revelation to transcend an Ensnare from far away, but doesn't quite get it. A little bit slow, actually, with the Ensnares here. Yeah. It feels like he should have been able to catch some of these Griffins, but Sock retaining six Griffin. He could actually heal up very easily with... he's got the staff up on the Archmage, could use that on the Beastmaster, then one Holy Light on the Archmage. He'd be full HP. Sock, just a master at managing this air army here. Getting two Griffins more now. It's going to be 55 supply to 68. That expansion from Hitman has been mining the whole time.
Yeah.
But the mains are running out. The main of Hitman is about to run dry. He could perhaps... I think he should long distance mine from the center, probably. There's no point in getting more lumber. And Sock is out of gold as well.
He's all
this
in.
This might be one last attack.
He's all in because, of course, if he were to expand, level 3 wolves, it would never do anything. He would just lose all of his peasants.
He's going to send Militia, which is actually going to make it very tricky for Hitman because a lot of the units are going to be attacking that instead of the air.
Yeah, and feeding more experience, not the end of the world at this point. Level 6 heroes could be the final push of the day. Can Hitman hold or will Sock equalize and take us to a game 5?
Yeah, we saw Chimiko against Exlord on this map. The conclusion, the last fight that was with all the Militia coming in, could be seeing the same thing here. Big Stomp and Lightning Shield on the TC gets rid of all the peasants instantaneously here. The Headhunter is taking a lot of damage. Everything's ensnared, but he chooses to pull back. There is too much critical mass and damage coming in from those Griffins.
Yeah, Hitman needs heal scrolls, absolutely. The splash damage is so good. The expansion is still up. Hitman knows all the time in the world is what he needs currently. Quill Beast in the back gonna kill a Headhunter. The Burrow will soon be killed. The Bear is killing the Peons. Is Sock really doing this with 47 supply? Of course, that's all fighting army currently. Hitman with nothing really to heal after that heal scroll is used. The stomp is big, the chain lightning is bigger, but is there enough for the orc?
There's still a mana potion on that Fastir. He knows it's not stomps that he needs, but more chain lightning against this air army. Wolves level 3 come into play. Why would you go earthquake against this mass Griffin? He just needs to hold and he's won the game. Griffins starting to run lower on hit points here, but the human hero is still pretty healthy. That one bear still being obnoxious this late in the game. Finally gets sniped. But Griffins, decently healthy. There's still staffs to work with here for Sock.
Oh my god, Sock was down to just 3 heroes at one point in this game. The Paladin, pretty low on mana. Does he have a Holy Light? No, of course, he has a staff to save everything. The trades have just been constantly in Sock's favor, and that's how you win with this strategy. The staff, the Holy Light, the armor. You trade efficiently, and that's how you can get the win. And I think Sock may have done it. Still a fighting chance for Hitman. The expansion is still mining, but he needs reinforcements.
Yeah, these summons, as much as a lot of them got purged, it didn't matter. They still did damage first and foremost, not just to the economy, but also in the fight. Griffins chasing down the last few Headhunters. Hitman has completely given up on any sort of Batriders because there is Devotion, there is plus 2 armor. Goes for the Beastmaster. Holy Light is there on time. There is still an Invuln as well that easily could be used. Hitman on 20 supply against 39. I cannot believe Sock might be doing this. It looked all over.
Wow. Yeah, and the thing is, yeah, Hitman just cannot get a unit kill. He just cannot get a unit kill to save his life. Level 7 on the Torn Chieftain. Now he's safe. The bear chasing down the last of the Headhunters. The Griffins killing the last of the economy for both players. But he who's left with an army is going to win the game. And this is 39 versus 16 in Sock's favor. This is looking like a game number 5.
Yeah, with staffs being there, with this many Griffins, with the upgrades, Storm Hammers doing a ton of damage. Archmage, of course, a big support here with Brilliance, allowing the Paladin to work with a lot of Holy Light. Surprisingly, he didn't go for Brilliance level 3 here with the Tri-Hero, but instead with Water Elementals for more damage.
That's the expansion down. Hitman down to 2 heroes.
And there's still a bear in his main base. I mean, this guy.
God. Now, if Hitman had a little bit of gold, I would dare say he's got a tiny, tiny chance. If he retrained doubly into Earthquake and Shockwave and went for Base Raise Hit and Run, but there's the Farseer, there's the GG, and we're going to a Game 5.
What madness is this, Carson? Up 2-0, it looked like Hitman had all the momentum in the world, but Sock, he goes for two out of the ordinary strategies here. With a fast expand on Last Refuge, I mean, it's not the most uncommon. But this air army with the Beastmaster, I think it just folded Hitman is what it was. And even though that happened, it was still really, really close because Hitman had the expansion up. But eventually, he wore him down to the point where he had a critical mass of Griffins. He needed to close it out.
Yeah, maybe, I mean, if Hitman maybe played a little bit more hit and run instead of defending the expansion, Sock just microed so well with the Griffins and the staves and the Holy Light and always having a summon at all times in the economy. Here we go, the beginning of the game. Started off with a very delayed attack, but the tier 3 was not too late, as Sock went instantly for that. And yeah, it was all Hitman all game. And honestly, could we call this an NA LOL throw?
Oh, please don't. I don't think so. I think Sock is just, they're both great players. And it was a very competitive game, regardless of, you know, the start and everything that was happening. That Farseer here almost was in a quite a dicey situation. I guess if he would have gotten surrounded here, he probably would have pulled the creeps and then TP'd out,
right,
make it tricky for the footmen to all get out of there. I cannot believe actually that he escaped this. I thought for sure that was a surround at some point. A bit of a delayed TP here by Sock.
Yeah.
Not sure that was the right move. I think that actually put him behind, but after that, he managed those fights beautifully. It's so easy to butcher the fight against like the big fights,
for
against
sure,
like the Batriders and the Raiders and stuff. I think he used the Scrawlers at the perfect time, the staffs, the Holy Lights and all that.
Yeah, the Dragonhawk Rider was always on point, at least getting the first Batrider. If he allowed two to connect, it would have been rough, especially just the flash the splash damage, rather. Even if you don't get that single kill, just killing or doing that damage, forcing the heal scroll early even is very, very important early on. And I feel like Sock was the one to have the better micro through and through.
Yeah.
Even he was down, what, 15 supply? It looked a little more uneven because so many peasants died. It was really, I think, 5 gold peasants and a shredder, whereas it would normally be, you know, about 5 extra supply in peasants. So
I'm so happy, Carson. We're getting a map 5.
Yeah.
You and I.
I know, right?
I thought
I thought it was going to be another fast expo. And
a 3-0 would have still been okay because, you know, like, whichever player advances here deserves it, right? But you want to see a 5 mapper here for sure. We're going to end things up on Tidehunters. The game on which Sock yesterday against Soin had the longest and craziest game that I've seen in a while.
This is the map of the tournament. Every game we've almost seen on this map has been super epic. I don't think we've had a terrible, boring, one-sided game, well, in the tournament, but definitely not on Tidehunters so far. So this is a great decider to have in our first game 5 of the entire tournament. Yeah, wow, I'm stoked for this one. What is the strategy going to be from Sock? We know what it's going to be from Hitman. He's going to play reactionary. He's going to play with that Farseer. But for Sock, he's had a different strat almost every game now.
Maybe another expo. Yeah. Does he finally play purely standards?
Maybe. I wonder how confident he is. He's got to be confident. And he certainly is after winning 2 maps in a row, I'm sure. And in the upper left of Tidehunters, it is Sock.
His opponent in the red, playing Orc. It is North America's Hitman. We saw Hitman on camera for a second.
Right.
Do you think he looked maybe a little shaken here?
Maybe a little bit. I think towards the end of the game, I was looking over to his camera and he looked a little flustered, like, oh my God, how am I not winning this fight? He's microing so good right now. So maybe feeling the pressure.
You know him very well. Do you think he handles emotions well, mostly, or
very well? Yeah,
mid-series?
He's an ice-cold killer when it comes to at least Warcraft.
What about post-series?
Post-series? I haven't seen him tilt too much in the past. He's normally pretty good, and I think, you know, both players are going to be quite happy with their performance here regardless, but of course, would be upsetting. A reverse sweep can always be heartbreaking, but I think we've got to give definitely credit to Sock for just the balls he's had to do these strategies to make them both work.
Yeah, and you were talking about his potential strategy on this map. This is the map on which he expanded against Soin and made it look pretty good, to be fair. That was one where, he had to battle really hard to eventually win the game, but it seems like he just knows all the appropriate steps to take to make that expansion work with the perfect farm position, the right amount of towers, never too few, never too many. So I wonder if he tries something like that. There's the big mind game of what does he think is going to be his opponent's creep route. Does he think that Hitman's going to be creeping in the center, in which case it might be okay to creep that Expo quickly and secure it with the Arcane Tower like he did against Soin.
Yeah, for Hitman, of course, he's not going for that Grunt opener, which generally means you're going to creep, but on Titan, you don't need it. And immediate expansion? Is Hitman just going to blind run over there, or is he going to take the turtles? Of course, he can get level 2, but it looks as though... The question is, will he send one of the wolves to scout the expansion?
Yeah.
He's not going to be able to be there when Sokka's creeping, but he'll be able to be there for the peasants.
He knows.
He's blind running there.
Yeah. It's Sok. He's been playing with a lot of expansion recently. He's like, he's going to do it again. I can feel it. So he heads over, and Hitman's looking for some serious damage. Perhaps some steel. Doesn't quite get the Wet Elemental, actually.
It doesn't quite get the last hit either on that little Murloc. Putting damage on the Archmage, of course, that should be the first priority if the Archmage is low. It's very difficult to defend the expansion. Previously, when Hitman was successful against the expansion, remember, he killed some peasants in the main base at the same time. This time, though, he doesn't have that level 2 or that Grunt.
Dude, I love that. I love the decision of pulling back, by the way.
Yeah.
Because, like, he would have had peasants there and just started losing them.
He's just tacking.
Yeah, I think this might be a creep route where he creeps this first. If the opponent doesn't show up, he takes the expo. If he shows up, you just go back and tech. You're happy either way.
It's brilliant, actually. He's not going to have level 2 for quite a while. He's going to have to sneak into the camp and could always split militia creep the green to the south of his base. But this is great. It's a great sort of countering. I think it counters Hitman in a way just going blindly to that expansion and not creeping the level 2.
Yeah, Hitman, though, this... Feels like it's already pushing him a little bit out of his comfort zone. He needs to resummon those walls. He has to not feed any experience. He's going to do that very, very well here. There is no tower, and Sok moved away from his base. Peasants are going to start dying left and right very, very quickly. And as someone who's had some games against Hitman in this kind of scenario, I can tell you it's very scary.
Yeah.
Sok is running home. This is a disaster.
No.
He had a great start, but then he got a little over-ego. He took a gamble, and Hitman is going to punish him hard here for this. Even if he saves some of these peasants here, he's already lost some, and he's losing so much mining time on lumber. His lumber economy is going to be in absolute shambles this game.
And defend is going to kick online, but 60 lumber after that, and Fourth Header meets up with the army. And yeah, generally when you're doing this to the orc, you're like, okay, he's going to be level 3, so I got to start preparing for that. But Sok, just little does Hitman know, he just ran all the way across the map and then ran all the way back.
Yeah.
Hitman's in a great position, as good as you could be in these early games.
He didn't get that many snipes yet. But a lot of these peasants are already low, and there's still no tower on the way. That's the big thing. Like, when there is no tower here, it's really like the floodgates being purely open. Look, he's catching every peasant that's mining on the lumber.
The peasant. All this experience so far is from peasants, and it has been... Okay, he got a trapper as well, apparently. I think, what, 4 or 5 peasants so far?
Yeah. Really quite disastrous here for Sok. I think he might have to make a lumber mill, and maybe the... improve lumber harvesting upgrade to try and catch up, because look at his gold already in lumber comparison.
Yeah.
And the thing is, he's going to get harassed more here potentially as well. It's not over. This assault will be ongoing here.
Is Sok a little bit lost? He just ran out into the middle of the map and ran all the way back, realizing Hitman was taking his green, and defend is here, but there's Chain Lightning, there's a Grunt, and I don't think Hitman will get much more done, at least when Sok is right in front of his base, but Hitman's happy with this. His tier 2 is done. No opportunity at all for a Beastmaster harass. Oh! I completely lied. He's going for it still.
He wants to counter pressure. He does have defense, so... But he goes bear first. For a long time, the standard, when you would, you know, back in the old day, you would tower rush with your first few casters, like 2 sorceresses. Everybody would go Quill Beast because there were just a lot of extra damage. You need too much extra tankiness, and also they were very good at chasing and canceling south.
For sure. Oh, staff in. Okay, that's an excellent play from Sok. That is some way he can close the gap.
The Archmage won.
So crazy. PC's about to be out. Could stomp and block, potentially. Oh, this is going to have to be a town portal. Oh, never mind. The Archmage just slips away. Hitman, PC out, can stomp. But what does he stomp? He's going to stomp the heroes and the footmen, trying to save the bestiary. Sok is taking damage to his main base
Hitman
at the same
needs to repair.
Time.
Don't lose that bestiary. I mean, he's still somewhat healthy. Kills one of those footmen. He's counter-attacking as the militia here. There is enough headhunters that is doing so much damage. I think this is better for Hitman, but he needs to defend properly at home against this many. He might have to TP actually against this many footies.
Yeah, he might have to TP and try to force that Archmage to town.
But this is dead. He can't go anywhere. He's stuck in his own base.
Oh, and Hitman, he won't
he dug his own
block.
Grave.
he can get the TC back. He's got the gold. Oh, is the base open? The Grunt got in there.
I think the Grunt should go in there, but the Sok's
evacuating. What the hell are we seeing in the last game of the day, Todd?
This is absolute madness. Just pandemonium on both sides here. The Burrows falling very rapidly.
The Beastmaster's so low. The TC's gonna come back. I don't think Sock can do anything.
Barkin
is
spikes. He's gonna help out so much against those footmen. Onto the burrows here.
Oh my god, the spikes is such an excellent choice. Brute Strength also coming out. There's still peons up and alive. And does Sock have any? Sock is building peasants back at his main base, but there's now level 2 wolves there. And Hitman Town Portal's back home. How well can he defend?
Hitman doesn't have many peons left. I think he's got like 6 or 7, so he needs to make sure he keeps those alive because he's big time supply bots. You want to be mining with at least 5 peons and building burrows with 1 or 2.
Right.
So I think that's why he TP'd now, because if he would have lost more, that would have been disastrous here. He wanted to save at least the 1 burrow. On the other side, he left wolves instead of the peasant line. And Sock is not realizing he's still losing peasants.
My god.
Sock just has three peasants on the map there in the center. They were very far away. And he's doing it. He nearly taps out. Hitman makes it to the semifinals.
Unbelievable game 5. Hitman does it for North America. And, you know, sorry if I sound a little bit excited, Todd. But, yeah, that was quite the performance. I mean, shout out there to Sock. An excellent comeback. Nearly had it. A crazy game 5. Both players probably sweating up a storm. But America does it today. Semi-final against Laliat tomorrow. What a great series.
USA number 1, Carson. The seed 1 and 2 here in points. Happy and Hitman gets placed on each side of the bracket, and they both succeed in their quarterfinals journey. Perhaps the grand finals to be, but Laliat and Moon will try and say something about this tomorrow.
Yeah, the American dream, and we'll see what the desk has to say about it. Here we go.
Oh my goodness. The desk has a lot to say about it. I made notes, I lost them, it doesn't matter. I think it's safe to say we saved the best for last today. What a quarterfinals that was. I am joined by the Golden Boys of Back to Warcraft. Neo, what on earth did I just witness?
I'm not sure if my audio is working.
Then I'll start with Remo. Remo, what did I just witness?
A mad game, a full best of 5, a back and forth. Hitman starting off super strong. That first map right away showing what's up. It's starting to look like the reverse comeback. We see the highlights right here. This is where it started off all so well, right? On Shallow Grave, Hitman there. Nothing seemed to be able to stand in his way. Sock kind of lost there in the beginning, but would find his footing later.
First two games, it was all Hitman. Even in the third game, I didn't hate it all that much. Maybe it wasn't going that great. Then he lost the Tauren Chieftain with the greater healing. I was like, all right, that could be a real shift in momentum. And it truly was, Neo.
I have to do the interview, but that was freaking crazy, man. The resiliency, the way, like, how much he learned in the past couple of months and years, it's just, the rise of Hitman is impressive.
We started the day with all 3 regions still represented, and going into the semifinals tomorrow, all 3 regions will still be represented. We've got 2 Koreans, a Russian, and an American in the semifinals. Remo, I absolutely love the series. And then the craziness in game 5 as well. Somebody said they're gonna just play passive, right? I was like, not necessarily. It could be all out aggression, and it was all out aggression.
Hitman, what a great performance and a run for him already. 4th place, $10,000 guaranteed. Beginning of this year in the regional finals for America, he had to bow out and give that title to Cruncher, which the human was certainly proud of. But here now, Hitman proving who really is the best, not just in America, but across the world. One of the best players out there in Warcraft 3.
And I mean, if he would have done it 3-0, sure, it would have felt great. But when you face some adversity, when you're being pushed to the limit, but you still get the job done in game 5, that has to feel even better. Let's just hear from the man himself as he is joined by Neo.
Part of all the DreamHack seasons, the winner interview with Hitman. Dude, 17 years in the making, NA in a semi-final. That series was crazy. What was going through your head? Tell me either it's roller coaster of emotions.
Well, after I won the first 2 games really quickly, I thought I was in a really good position because I knew I just had to beat him in 1 out of 3 games. So I was feeling really confident, but the map pool is a little human favored, so I feel like when I played on him on Last Refuge, it didn't start off very well, and things kind of just started going downhill. And I just had to get myself together, and just make sure to shore up all my weaknesses, and make sure I didn't make any stupid mistakes. I feel like I played really, really well in the first 2 games, and then at the start of the 3rd game, I missed a chain lightning on the creep, and I don't know. It was just a really tough series all around, but I'm just glad I was able to pull it out in the end.
Yeah, we talked to you yesterday evening. You didn't sound too confident, and you show up here like Super Saiyan level. What was the Hitman's key to success today?
I just try to relax and take it easy right before the match, because yesterday I was, two days ago, I was really stressed in the group stage, and I feel like it showed a lot in my gameplay. So today I just tried to relax and make sure I was in the right frame of mind to play the series. Coming into the series, I was very relaxed, so I felt very confident in my gameplay. I played a lot of practice games with Cruncher right before, and I was doing really well, so I was feeling confident, even though I haven't had a great track record against him on ladder. I was able to pull out the win in the end.
Tomorrow, semifinal versus Lawliot. We know you hate Night Elf. Any chance that you succeed despite that?
Yeah, as all orcs know, Elf is really hard to beat, but I feel like I'm not particularly bad in the matchup. It's just a hard matchup in general for orcs, but I definitely feel like I have a chance against Lawliot. I feel like I've beaten him quite a bit in the past, both on ladder and in tournaments. Like going back to DreamHack Anaheim, where I 2-0'd him, I feel like I'm prepared and ready to repeat that result this time around. Yeah.
It's been kind of a tradition here when I interview you after a big success. Of course, the road is not over yet, but the biggest earnings of your career now, what do you do with the money?
Don't know if I can say that on camera, Neo. You know that.
Perfect, Hitman. That's what I was looking forward to. All right, that is Hitman up in the semifinals tomorrow against Lawliot. And we're going back to Roddy and Remo.